could be in jeopardy. Tonight, two local families are feeling the effects of Mideast strife. As News Center 5's Rebecca Rollins reports, after a dramatic escape, one family feels relief. But for the other, uncertainty continues.
For the Eldari family of Arlington, a week of emotional strife ended with Monsef's courageous escape from occupied Kuwait.
It was a six-hour, drive from the Iraqi border to the hotel, and I needed transportation. So I wasn't sure at all when I left that I would go through. I took a chance. I said to myself, I have nothing to lose.
Thousands of other civilians trapped by the Iraqi invasion remain out of contact with American family members. Hassan Lari last spoke with his sister, who lives in Kuwait, 3 weeks ago about her plans to visit Boston. He has mixed feelings, he says, knowing American troops are standing by.
To tell you the truth, I'm a little more concerned about it because this could go the other way, too. It is so inflammatory that you don't know what could anything could happen any time. I mean, just we are sitting on a time bomb.
Egyptian President Hosni Mubarak said today there is no peaceful solution to the present Middle Eastern standoff. Native-born Farouk Elbaz of Boston University believes his countryman was only sounding a warning.
I don't really think he meant there will be war, but he's saying that the situation is so bad, we're getting so close to an explosion that we better sit down and talk about it and find an Arab solution to it.
To those watching the Middle Eastern political situation, the advice Elbaz gives is wait and see. It's the only plan the Laris have for their missing family. Rebecca Rollins, News Center 5, tonight.
Here in New England, you probably...